14, MER Project Manager.
14.
I wanted to say, with the completion of tonight's commanding, this concludes operations for MER-1, spacecraft ID 253. And on behalf of the entire MER project, we'd like to thank the DSN for over 15 and a half years of outstanding support from launch until tonight. That support has made is one of the reasons why this mission has been so successful. And once again, the DSN has helped us to make history. Thank you.
And this is Station 14 on behalf of the network. Thank you for your comments, and it's a sad day for all of us.
14, you are released.
And 14 copies.
MER project off the net.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, main engine start, 0, and liftoff of the Delta rocket with Opportunity, a chance to explore and unlock the secrets of our neighboring planet.
The transients at liftoff.
Getting a bounce to signal. We're getting a bounce signal.
Spacecraft is bouncing and alive on Mars. However, this bouncing will take place another 10
signal
minutes.
Signal has stopped. Hold on.
We have a momentary loss of signal as the spacecraft is bouncing on the surface. It is difficult to maintain lock. We need to reacquire the signal to have positive confirmation of a safe landing. As the spacecraft is bouncing on the surface of Mars and rolling around, the antenna is pointed in many different orientations.
We're seeing it on the LTP. Very strong on LTP.
We have a very strong signal in the left-hand polarization channel, indicating that we still have a safe
landing. We're getting a signal on RCP as well.
This mission accomplished so much more than we wanted to. It's just, it's mind-boggling to me. I mean, if you had told me around the time we landed that Spirit and Opportunity were going to each accomplish one quarter or one tenth of what they ultimately did, I would have been thrilled. So it went, and it's because of the longevity of the vehicles. You know, Spirit lasted six some odd years, Opportunity 14 and a half, when we were designing it for 90 days. One thing that I try very hard to do, and when I talk to my teammates, I tell them the same thing, is don't ever, ever, ever get to the point where you take this for granted. We have been given the opportunity by a team of engineers 15 years ago who built just two of the most extraordinary pieces of space exploration hardware ever conceived and built. We were given an incredible, sort of unprecedented opportunity. You only get to do something like this for the first time once.
We're sad to say goodbye, but we have to remember all the magnificent time that we had with this this great explorer on the surface of Mars, much more than we thought we ever would have with it. I mean, we were excited by 90 days, and 14 and a half years is just almost incomprehensibly remarkable, and how much we have rewritten the Martian history books as a result of those 14 and a half years of fantastic exploration. This more recent severe dust storm had a very sudden increase in atmospheric capacity. Literally within a couple days, it went from one, which is sort of normal at this time of year, up to beyond the last measurement we had from the rover, which was 10.8. That was a historic high measurement. Never before has any observation of Mars shown an atmospheric capacity that high. That is truly dead of night during the day for the rover. And so the rover couldn't generate any energy with that. And so we saw the rover just shut down. And there was nothing we could do at that point because it didn't have power to keep going. And we just had to wait. And that's what we did do, is wait and wait and wait.
Yeah, the rovers changed fundamentally kind of our paradigm for exploration for Mars. So before Spirit and Opportunity, the mantra was follow the water. We were really interested in finding evidence that there was once liquid water on the surface of Mars. We thought there had been based on our orbital data, but we hadn't proven it. You can't prove it until you actually can get down and get your nose in the dirt. So with those rovers, we proved that, and now we've been able to move beyond that. So now instead of just following the water, what we're doing is we're trying to understand what was the chemistry of the water? How long did that water persist? Was that water something that could have given rise to life? Why did the environment change so much on Mars that we once had liquid water and we don't anymore? Opportunity in particular is a really special rover for me. I was actually a high school student when Opportunity landed, and I had this incredible opportunity to come to JPL as part of an outreach program run by the Planetary Society to be in the room with the scientists when Opportunity landed on Mars. And so I was in the room when Opportunity sent back that first picture from Eagle Crater. And that night is like burned in my brain. I will never forget it. It was such a dramatic image of Mars, and it was so different than any images we've seen before.
The Mars Exploration Rover mission brought mobility to surface exploration of Mars. That's a huge concept, and it's something that we're using all the time now, even with Curiosity and then again with Mars 2020, and also with human exploration and robotic exploration of other surfaces, such as the Moon. Forever, Opportunity will be a monument of exploration on the surface of Mars and a testament of a hugely successful mission that this agency and these teams have put together.
Remember at the time, back in the early 2000s, we didn't know for sure whether Mars had had significant water standing out on the surface in its ancient past. Spirit and Opportunity helped us prove that. They found evidence through the discovery of things like the hematite blueberries, the sulfates on the other side of the planet that Spirit was able to locate, that were all indicative of minerals and geological processes that result from long-term exposure to water. So that helped nail down the theory and really confirm the idea that the possibility of lakes, ponds, oceans on the surface of Mars was a very realistic potential. Some simple facts and figures, we were able to drive the rovers a combined total of over 45 kilometers between the two rovers. Opportunity alone drove over 42 kilometers. That's like driving from Battery Park at the south end of Manhattan all the way up to Scarsdale, New York. Originally, these were rovers that were just going to go 600 meters, three times or four or five times the length of a football field, but instead they did much, much more than that. They were going to return a few hundred pictures. Between the two rovers, we actually returned over 350,000 images from the surface of Mars.
It made Mars real. It brought the excitement to the world, to the public, to the community, to the research community. And it actually showed that it could be quite possible for crews to live and work on the surface of Mars. It made it a tangible, real destination. It taught us how to do surface operations. It taught us how to read the terrain and navigate and plot a safe path from one point to another. We did not know how to do those. It was all speculative. But until we got down onto the surface and into the terrain and actually experienced it, we were hoping for 90 days. We got 15 years almost out of it. It provided the foundation for what we do on Mars with our rovers today.
It actually helped inspire the next generation of scientists and engineers. So these are people who saw the landing of the Mars Exploration Rovers, got it excited about it, starting learning more about science or engineering, and now some of them are professionals working on the mission. And I think that's fantastic in terms of getting people excited and providing the opportunity for people to actually fulfill their dreams. It really helped us figure out how to explore in the future. So the interplay between the rover operating and what it's finding, comparing to orbital data that you're getting, orbital data inform you what would be the next best target and that sort of thing. That really helped set the stage for how we would do future exploration. And with Curiosity, and we plan to do this with Mars 2020, is use those assets that we have to further our capabilities as we explore beyond this area that we study specifically for the landing sites.